Mr. Kumar, are you working?
Yes.
Where?
JSW Steel Limited, Toronto, Qatar.
JSW Steel, you know. So why do you wish to join civil service?
Sir, two reasons, personal and professional. Personally, I have been working in JSW Steel since last 8.5 years. But the level of satisfaction which the civil services provide, I am not, but as for getting that satisfaction, not to that level in this plan. And what is my personal reason is my interaction with my parents. My father is an assistant teacher in government basic school. My mother is an actually nursing midwife in health department. The level of satisfaction and personal goodwill what they have achieved in their service life, I think it's a better opportunity.
Right. So, what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
First, compassion. Compassion in the sense that I think I get more satisfaction when I am able to help someone. I am able to help someone in the sense that I am able to make them self-sufficient or empower them. To
if you could just narrate the quality, like you say,
compassion, integrity,
yeah.
Empathy,
yes,
and yes.
All right. Good. Is this your first attempt?
No, this is my fifth attempt and first interview.
First interview. Okay. Pushing?
Yes. Mr. Raushan Kumar.
Yes, sir.
You know, for financing of political parties during elections, the government had announced a scheme. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir.
What is it
called? Electoral bonds.
Electoral bonds. Now, what is the procedure? What are the basic principles of this electoral bonds?
The basic principle is of this electoral bond is to ensure that financing to political parties goes through a secure medium, through banks, and while maintaining anonymity of the donating organization or person, and to make the political parties accountable, because they will have to announce that whatever donation they get through electoral bond,
because it's all on record, right? But now, the electoral bond scheme has also given two stipulations regarding which political parties can receive this financing. What are those?
I am not able to recall exact percentage, but they need to secure fixed percentage of votes.
That's right.
For getting eligible. And they need to report
recognized political party
and minimum voting percentage.
Minimum 1% of votes in the last assembly election.
Yes.
Which basically means that if you create a new party today, you would not be eligible for this kind of electoral bond. Now this scheme has been challenged by the CPM, by Sitaram Yechury in particular. Do you have any idea why?
I am not exactly aware of his opinion, but overall there is a chance that overall it goes through banking medium, and government may access that data, which can invade the privacy or.
Very good. Basically, he was saying that this anonymity of the donor, which he has challenged, questioned that.
Okay.
Now, you know, this Organization of Islamic Conference, they had a meeting recently. What was so significant about this meeting?
First time, Indian External Affairs Minister was invited as the guest of honor for this meeting. Despite that, India has tried to be a member of Islamic Conference since its inception. But through long follow-up and diplomatic attempts, we have been able to secure that honor.
Where was it held? Any idea in which region of the world?
Probably UAE.
Abu Dhabi. Now, you know, have you heard of this person called Jamal Khashoggi?
Yes.
Who is he?
He was a journalist working for Washington Post.
Right.
And he went to Turkey to get some document for his marriage, getting married. And he was murdered inside the consulate office, and his body disposed. And Saudi Arabia continuously denied that he has visited office, but he went out. But later they accepted
that he
was killed in the operation called
Rock. It is being alleged that somebody very high up in the hierarchy in Saudi Arabia is involved in this.
Yes.
Who? What is the allegation?
Allegation is that the level at which this entire operation was managed definitely indicates that someone higher up has authorized this operation. Because on the same day,
well, that's true. But is there any finger being pointed?
Yes, around Crown Prince.
On the Crown Prince, that's right. On the Crown Prince, that possibly. Okay. Now, since IPS is your first choice, let me ask you something on this problem of terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir. After the Pulwama incident, a terror group has claimed responsibility for this. Which group was that?
Lashkar-e-Taiba.
Jaish-e-Mohammed. Now, can you tell me something about the leader of this group?
Yes, he's Maulana Masood Azhar. He was in Indian jail in 1994 to 1999 till he was released as a compromising Kandahar hijack. After that, he perpetrated this parliament attack, and he was also active in this
parliament attack. And then later in 2016 January, one more.
Pathan.
Yes. So why was he in the news apart from this Masood Azhar? Recently, after the Pulwama attack, was some attempt made in the UN Security Council?
Yes, sir. India tried to enlist him on global list of terrorists and to prevent his movement and financial routing him through United Nations Sanction Committee 1267.
Thank you.
Raushan, you are working in the JSW still.
Yes.
Now, did your company participate in any of the resolution proceedings under the IBC?
Yes, sir.
And they what was the outcome?
Yes, they have acquired Moonlight Ispat in Chhattisgarh.
Right.
And right now they are involved in this acquisition of the Bhushan Steel and Power Limited. They are having 3 million ton plant in Odisha. This is in process, but they have already successfully acquired Moonlight Ispat.
So what is your assessment, overall assessment, on the performance of the steel sector?
Sir, I'm mostly talking about after 2016. 2016 and 17 was a tough period for the steel sector due to dumping of cheap steel from South Korea, China, and Japan. But after that, government took a number of steps that they imposed minimum import price, anti-dumping duty, and countervailing duty. After that, demand for steel is picking up, and all these government flexi programs like Pradhanmantri Awas Yojana, Smart City Mission, and Public Amrut Yojana, they are taking the consumption of steel up. And right now, Indian steel sector is growing at around 4 to 5%. That is, prospects are high. That is the reason that major companies are showing interest in acquiring all those assets which are under IBC.
Okay, good. Now, the aviation sector in India is said to be facing some turbulence.
Yes.
Can you name some factors which have contributed to this situation?
Sir, one thing I know that we are charging higher air turbine fuel surcharge on fuels used by.
It has been there for quite some time. I'm referring to more recent developments.
More recent developments, one I recall that many planes have been grounded due to technical malfunctions.
What are those planes?
One is Airbus Neo plane, which this Boeing.
It is Boeing 737 MAX 8,
which crashed in Ethiopian Airlines.
Yeah. So how has it impacted? Which were the airlines which were operating these aircraft?
One was Jet Airways, but they have already grounded due to financial reasons. Mm-hmm. But SpiceJet has grounded planes which were already in.
Okay, so one is this Boeing 737,
yes.
And you briefly mentioned about Jet. What is the problem with Jet Airways?
Sir, progressively their market share in aviation sector has gone down, and. They are not able to.
No, what is the problem they are facing?
One is they are facing shortage of pilots also.
No, they themselves have de-rostered many pilots. The shortage is not an issue. They are facing severe financial crisis.
Yes, sorry.
So, who are the. And the committee of creditors,
yes,
those who had lent out money to the Jet Airways,
yes,
They are now seriously thinking of resorting to IPC. Because one of their major partners, Etihad Airways, they have refused to bail them out.
Yes,
so, read this out.
Yes,
why is Mr. Mukesh Ambani in the news, apart from the allegations made against him in the Rafael case? I am not referring to that. Why is he in the news?
Sir, pardon, I think it's Anil Ambani.
Yeah, sorry. Okay, Anil Ambani, yes, yeah. But Mukesh also comes into the picture,
yes,
in a way.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Because he court has initiated contempt charge against him due to failing to pay Erickson for the said amount,
right.
Amount 500 crores.
Hmm.
But yesterday they paid the amount and obeyed with the Supreme Court order.
Yeah, they paid up with help from the elder brother.
Yes.
Okay. You have heard about the PM Kisan Nidhi.
Yes, sir.
Any idea how many beneficiaries have so far benefited from this scheme?
Sir, I'm not able to recall the exact number.
It's close to 28 million, 27.6 to be precise.
Yes, sir.
There are some states who have not participated in this particular scheme.
Yes,
can you name them?
If you allow, I can make a guess.
Please.
It's West Bengal.
Yeah. One. There are other states as well.
Other airport.
No? Okay. Now, your interest is watching movies.
Yes, sir.
Have you seen Badla?
Yes, sir.
Which genre belongs to this particular movie?
Suspense thriller.
Or crime.
Okay.
Thank you.
You won an award in innovation. Innovation Championship. What was this about?
Ma'am, in our company, there was an Innovation Championship organized for Pinterest plant, technical plant level.
So, what innovative work did you do?
Not only I did, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, we as a team, representing this gas mixing and boosting section, gas section,
mm-hmm.
we designed a system which was used to purge the gas line with nitrogen gas from ground level. We didn't need to go to higher at height. To monitor the level of purging.
So this was being done for the first time?
In our knowledge, it was for the first time.
All right. Good. Now you're from Bihar.
Yes, ma'am.
How has prohibition, alcohol, how has that affected the society in Bihar?
There are some positive outcomes.
Mention
like it has empowered women.
How?
One, my personal experience. Ma'am.
No personal experience, just tell me how.
Right now, the men which used to spend their money in drinking.
Yes.
Now that money is somehow coming in hands of women and they are able to spend it on health, education and some small business activity like fruit selling and vegetable selling.
So one is they are getting more money. Anything else?
Anything
other? Has crime against women like domestic violence gone down?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
But now they say that people are moving to drug addiction. Is that also correct? So, what is the government doing in this respect?
Government is taking steps to make people aware and government is trying to make it a people's movement by engaging NGOs and most importantly, government school teachers.
Okay. And are they also de addiction centers?
Yes, they are open but not aware of
it. Now, sociology is your subject. We hear these concepts urbanization, westernization, modernization. How are these three factors affecting the values of the young people, of the new generation?
Urbanization,
yes.
Westernization,
and modernization. You can take anyone if you think any of these have an impact on the values of the new generation, young generation.
Oh, I choose westernization.
Alright.
But I know youth is focusing more on this individual liberty. Means they want to exercise more agency in their decision making choices like in education, job, marriage, and property holding.
So would you say that institution of marriage is also undergoing a change?
Not fundamentally, but overall it is going to change that expectations from marriage and the degree of compatibility desired by potential couples is increasing.
Anything else that you see as a change in marriage?
And marriage is becoming more egalitarian in the sense husband and wife are more,
yes,
more willing to share the responsibilities, household responsibilities.
Anything else? The types of marriages which are taking place?
Yes.
To some extent?
Yes.
Can you mention?
Like marriage.
Intercaste marriage,
interreligious marriage, and pre-marriage courtship like living relationship.
Yes, living relationships. But so would you say this is an effect of urbanization because there is anonymity? Nobody knows about the caste, people don't know generally about religion?
To some extent. But this is more being affected by their economic status, class status.
Okay, thank you.
Mr.
Raushan
Kumar.
Yes, sir.
You are from Muzaffarpur, right?
Yes,
tell us something about the potentiality of Muzaffarpur, other than Lichi.
Yes, sir. So one thing, Muzaffarpur is hub for this textile. Textile export and import, which is coordinated from Surat.
Anything else?
And it can be a hub for tourism to Sitamarhi, which is
it's a gateway to Nepal.
Not exactly.
Exactly, but
yes,
that's an important term.
Yes.
Okay. So this is just passing reference. You had worked in JSW Steel for about 8 years.
I worked.
You are still working. Okay. So from your experience, can you some best practices in JSW which you can imbibe and introduce in the company?
First important thing, housekeeping. Housekeeping, we are having the second best practices of housekeeping, means to following 5 years to putting things in a place and a place for everything.
Okay.
And second is we have planted more than 2 million trees in that arid region of Torangal, which is in drier, which comes in drier region of Karnataka. And third is safety practices. We have applied high level of safety practices in different different units of our
JSW has also made significant contribution on CSR.
Yes, sir.
At local level. What is meant, what is the CSR provision in the company, sir?
They have tie up with a technical institution to develop the ITN, industrial technical training in the area, and they are giving training to for technicians, electricians, fitters, welders, and they are giving them employment opportunities.
So, can I take it beyond? What are the main problems of Bihar? You are from Bihar.
Yes.
Tell me something about the problems of what are the main problems?
Main problem is the lack of a vibrant private sector, which gives employment opportunity to a significant population. And there are many.
That you can't call it a problem because there are just no opportunities, no scope for private industries.
Yes, sir. Due to infrastructure.
It's basically an agrarian state.
Yes, sir.
And any other problem?
Lawyer.
Human Development Index?
Yes.
That's a And what are the what is meant by Human Development Index? How is it computed?
So Human Development Index is computed on three aspects. One is life expectancy, and per-capita income and education.
In respect of these parameters, how will you place Bihar?
Out of 1 out of 10?
Very low?
Yeah, very low.
But relatively speaking, which one the performance is improving?
Health.
Health.
Yes.
Right. Christchurch, what happened a couple of days ago, as an aspiring IPS officer, what is your take on that? Globalism may throw in the globe, I think. Terrorism is on the increase. Yesterday again, I think in Netherlands.
Yes, sir, actually.
So, how do you see this? What is your take on that?
Sir, there are multiple aspects on this one. One is we are not able to address the problem alienation among the section of society, which is more a problem in societies which are diverse.
Mm-hmm.
And second, we are not able to anticipate the.
Is there any common threat? The increase of terrorism throughout the globe.
One important threat is growing Islamophobia since 9/11.
Yeah, that's an important
thing. Another is the rise of right wings in multiple countries, across the globe, in Western Europe and US also.
Here, gun culture?
Yes,
big in the USA and New Zealand also. Right. Okay. I'll ask you something. Hostile takeover. We have seen very much in the news, and recently, very difficult on happened only yesterday. One of the companies trying to take over since you have worked in the corporate sector for a long time.
Yes, sir.
You will know something. What is meant by hostile takeover? No idea. Okay, skip it. Last question. Encounters are on the increase. Again, something related to your police. So why is it so?
So there is a sense of frustration, and you can say guilty perception among public as well as among police men also, that the law, normal course of law through the judicial system is not able to do its job properly. That's why criminals are not getting punished at required rate and within required time.
So if you are appointed to the police, IPS, what will your, what kind of position you will take? How will you check doing
sir, there are some special opportunities to the policemen for ensuring that this conviction of criminals take
sensitization
in a way that like in Bihar happened, what is happened in Bihar during 2005-2010. But I have said that most of the criminals were arrested under arms. And when they were arrested under arms act, the witness were policemen. And they were more than willing to be a witness in court, and the criminals were punished swiftly.
Until 2017-18, India was net exporter of steel. Net exporter of steel. What has happened now? What is the situation in the current year?
In current year, we are importing up to 4 to 5 million tons of steel. One reason is that we are not able
to... We have lost that position of exporter. That's
the reason is we are not able to manufacture the high quality or this unique steel market, like electric steel, which are used in specialized products. Mm. One reason is that one. And another was the dumping by countries like South Korea, China, Japan.
So are we taking these dumping lying down?
No, we are taking
retaliated.
Yes, we are taking a
step. So what is,
one is,
what is the extent of dumping? First tell me. How much dumping has taken place in last one?
Sir, I am not exactly aware of that. Hmm.
Then, what have we done to prevent this dumping?
We have imposed minimum import price.
What is it? These are your subjects?
Yes.
Is GSW, is GST?
Yes, sir.
Oh. 15%, 20%? What
it is
25%,
sir. Eh? It's 25%.
25%?
Duty we have imposed.
So what effect it has had since it they were imposed?
And one more thing, that we have given priority to our local steel manufacturers while procuring for government projects.
That's okay. I am asking a question about what impact it has had. How much this dumping has helped us? That is the question I am raising.
Dumping has helped us.
Anti-dumping duty, okay, which we have, or countervailing duty, whatever you call them.
Yes, sir.
How much they have helped us?
One thing by data we can say that we are our steel sector is growing at the rate of 4-5%.
Okay. But has to be exact, you know. Or approximately.
It is around 4%.
Now sale is our Government of India's enterprise.
Yes,
why is it ailing? It is running in loss.
Yes, sir.
Why?
One thing is it is not competitive. Competitive is per manpower cost is higher in sale, and second is the plants are old. Most of the pipeline is.
Is there a case for disinvestment of these?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Are they on the list of disinvestment?
But government is looking for.
Yes or no?
Sir,
no,
sir,
idea. Or
sir.
Read yours.
Okay, sir, sir.
Bihar presents certain paradox. You know paradox?
Yes, sir. Contradictory.
Some contradiction within itself.
Yeah.
Can you identify some paradox?
Sir, Sir, one thing is that people of Bihar are excelling in all fields outside Bihar. And they
not,
are
not, in, not inside.
Not inside
Bihar. So then what is the reason? That is where the real paradox comes.
Real paradox that the people who are born and brought up in Bihar, those who should have given back.
All right, these are social factors.
Social factors.
On the economic factor, human development factor, do you find any paradox? Human parameter or economic or human development parameter or economic parameters, do you find any paradox? What is the growth rate?
It's around
17, 18.
17, not exactly.
11.3. It has registered the highest growth in the country,
yes,
right?
Yes, but it,
and human development, absolutely at rock bottom, 36 now. This is a stark paradox,
yes,
right? You are from Muzaffarpur.
Yes.
Muzaffarpur was a bad name,
yes,
but a very bad name.
Yes, sir.
Right?
That there was a case of sexual exploitation of girls in the shelter, Mujapur shelter home, run by an NGO.
And who was running that NGO? A minister's wife or minister? Or who was it?
Not minister, but they were in close association with Brijesh Thakur.
Who is he?
He's a local businessman as well as a local level politician also involved in politics.
So what was Supreme Court's decision?
They shifted the case from Mujapur to Delhi Saket Court and instructed to complete the getting in time on manner within 6 months. And shifted that person from to Bihar to Patiala.
And that NGO is still running that shelter home?
No.
Who has taken over?
Government of Bihar has taken over.
Has taken over.
And shifted to those two other shelter homes.
How many NGOs are running in the country?
Sir.
No idea.
I have it.
Huh?
Hello?
Alright.
It's around 30 lakhs.
You're right. 30 lakhs. Has Bihar benefit from bifurcation?
No, sir.
It has lost?
Yes, sir. Lost.
But it is resisting such good progress?
That is more due to low base effect.
Whatever it is, but it is resisting very good progress.
Yes, sir.
All you have lost is national wealth, nothing more.
Natural wealth and you have lost institutions also.
You have lost territory then?
Yes, sir. We have lost
that. Now, social justice provisions in the constitution which promotes social justice.
Yes,
name some in the part 3 which are enforceable, not DPs.
Right to education.
Okay.
Right to elementary education.
Alright.
And sir, lot of right to
be specific.
Emanating from article 20.
Be specific. Which articles?
Right to life.
No, that's not social justice. That is
right information.
That is not social justice. Right information. What? 14 to 18?
Oh, extremely sorry.
Untouchability, etc.
Article 17.
Very simple.
Yes.
Mechanical engineering is your subject?
Yes, sir.
What are the latest advances in this field of technology?
Sir, I am more aware of it in regarding steel plant.
But this is your field.
Sorry,
today, a man like me who is not a science man knows that mechanical engineering is using artificial intelligence to produce very innovative machines.
True, sir.
Right?
Right, sir.
Drones, etc.
Yes, drones and robots for
assembly. So you could have said all that.
Yes, sir.
Those are three different things. Three different thing.
Yes, sir. Three different things.
Right?
Right. Customized product.
And then driverless cars.
Yes, sir.
These are the advances.
Yes, sir.
Train 18 is an advance.
Yes, sir.
Correct or not? So you could have mentioned these.
Yes,
alright. We'll close the interview. I'm giving you a feedback. By and large, you have handled the interview nicely. Some areas where you should again take a look is your DAF again. DAF says you are from Bihar, so prepare yourself from Bihar. It's the disparities, it's contradictions, it's the good points, bad points, liquor ban, etc., whatever you want to ask. Second is sociology, right?
Third is steel. Steel sector, you must improve your knowledge. There can be some question. If someone is sitting there with knowledge of steel in the interview, he is going to grill you. So steel is another. Fourth is mechanical engineering. Then certain, I have not asked you for paucity of time, constitutional principles, like what is basic structure concept, what is due process of law, what is this reservation, this subject is now come up before the Supreme Court again, you know, 10%.
Yes, sir, yes.
What are the laws on this, what are the verdicts on it, Supreme Court verdicts. So how this is playing out, this 10% reservation, etc. Then current affairs, you were asked about electoral bonds, IOC, Khashoggi, terror, JNK terror, etc. PM Kisan, you know, these are important. So on this you will have to focus your attention and knowledge.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.